And there is really this starter, and there are firstly these electric connectors, but I have to press this area that I can remove this first connector and second connector, and cable is inside in this rubber boot in here, and this opens in that way, and then I need 10 millimeter or actually 12 millimeter socket. The socket and nut is 12 millimeter, and in that area short socket fits in just nice. Now I can rotate my socket by fingers, and there is nut. Nut opens, and it is nice Honda's nut. And now these cables are free, excellent. And then I can also open this connector in that way that these parts are loosened. And here is something else. There is something else in here, some another connector, what we can soon look. But now I open these bolts, and this is really interesting, because firstly there is really big bolt what keeps this gearbox connection also in here. Look, this is Honda's engineering, that big bolt, and I open that next. For that opening we need now 14 millimeter socket, and then of course longer this bar, that this bolt is quite tight, and there is not so much. Now it opens, excellent, and I can take that bolt away, and now I use my electric driver, because there is this quite much to rotate that bolt. And let's look at how I take that away in here. And there is really, really interesting Honda's big unique bolt. Look, this is Honda's engineering, that one long bolt what belongs in here in starter. Then there is second 12 millimeter bolt in here, down area, in here. And now I open that one, and it looks like that size. And now this starter, this should opens, but it is stuck. Now when starter is stuck, it is good that I carefully hit this size in that way, and now it moves, and after that I have to rotate that in same direction in using my some steel bar, and carefully that I don't damage this my starter. And there is actually small hole, yes, and now it opens so easily. There's nice, and now starter is almost free, and there's one connector in this down area, and really there is this connector point, and I have to disconnect this cable in here, that array in here. Okay, and this connector opens easily, so that I press in here down, and then carefully I pull out this thing. Excellent. And now starter is almost free, I have to only take one bolt in that area, 8 millimeter bolt away, there's small bolt, And there's really one small bolt, this 8mm bolt, what keeps these cables. And now I open that small bolt. And after that, there are small bolts. After that, these cables are loosened. Excellent. And I can take this my alternator now away in here. Excellent. And then we can go to look closer at that alternator. Okay, and then we look a little bit closer that starter, that who has been made that and what is quality level. This is about 10 to 15 years old, the starter, and when we look in that type code in here, we can see that what is this quality level. There are firstly this product code, and we can soon see, but before of that, there are those electric connectors, and engineering is nice, and we can, this solenoid, we can replace, there are bolts, we can open these bolts, but let's look at that product, and there is Honda's logo, and then when we look closer, we can see that there is Denso starter, and it is like Toyota quality, because Denso is Toyota's sub-company, and Denso makes starters to all Toyota and Lexus cars, and also to Hondas. And there is Japan made, this is Japan excellent factory, and there is this product code in that starter. And it is good to check that you have similar product code, or if you have another type, purchase similar type. And this is really Honda's starter for these R-series gasoline engines.